Today in the news, we got leaked pricing for AMD, a new USB, and more Switch hacks. What's up guys, I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. Last year, a retailer called Bizgram released some specs and the pricing of Intel's 9th generation line of CPUs, and they did so about a month in advance with surprising accuracy. Well, it looks like they are back at it again since they've just released some listings, and it includes the pricing for the Ryzen 3000 line of CPUs. Now, as usual, this info doesn't come directly from AMD, so salt needs to be applied. The prices are quite similar to older leaks from Adored TV, which is quite interesting. I don't want to spend the day on this topic, so let's just get into it. The Ryzen 3 series will see the 3300 at $111, the 3300X at $145, and the GPU equipped 3300G at the same $145. For Ryzen 5, the 3600 is listed at $200, the 3600X at $258, and the 3600G at $224. The Ryzen 7 has the 3700 listed at $336, with the 3700X at $370. And the rumored new Ryzen 9 line of CPUs has the 3800X at $505 and the 3850X at $561. Now, this price list is, of course, a conversion from Singapore money, so when it gets translated to US or Canadian dollars, we'll probably see some rounding up or down. Just so you know, pricing and name are the two things that can change before the launch of a product, so the grain of salt is pretty big here, so keep that in mind. Moving on, last week the USB standard had a bit of a shakeup. USB 3.0, 3.1, and 3.2 were renamed to USB 3.2 Gen 1, 3.2 Gen 2, and 3.2 Gen 2 by 2. What the hell? This change made absolutely no sense. They say that USB 3.2 Gen 2 by 2 is named this way because it's twice the speed of USB 3.2 Gen 2, but the 3.2 Gen 2 is also twice the speed of 3.2 Gen 1, so why not just call it 3.2 Gen 3? Anyways, all of this to let you guys know that this morning, the USB promoter group just announced that they would be working on USB 4. This new standard will be worked on in the middle of this year and will double once again the throughput of the fastest USB standard to date, USB 3.2 Gen 2x2. This means speeds of 40 gigabits per second, which means USB 4 will be as fast as Thunderbolt 3. Not only that, but Intel finally added Thunderbolt into the USB standard, which means that Thunderbolt will always be integrated into USB 4. That is a welcome change since that caused a bit of confusion when the USB-C standard came out. Next up, it looks like Nintendo Switch hackers are back at it again. Early last week, Max Keller showed us Android Q running on the console. The only problem was that it only ran on the CPU, so some work was still needed. Well, a few days ago, another Switch hacker by the name of Ben Imbushuo, I hope that's how you pronounce it, started work on porting Windows 10 to the Switch. Now, it is the ARM version of Windows 10, but damn, this is pretty impressive. Right now, it doesn't actually work. The system boots, but it goes right into recovery mode, saying that the device needs to be repaired. But the developer, Ben, thinks that this can work. The Nvidia Shield, which shares the same processor as the Switch, already had Windows RT ported to it. But Windows 10 on ARM is a much bigger endeavor. He does specify that, like the Android hack, there is a high likelihood that this mod would only allow for CPU performance. Anyways, Ben just got invited to a guild of hackers trying to port all kinds of OSs on the Switch, so I'm gonna follow the activity on there. Alright guys, that is pretty much it for the news. Hopefully you've enjoyed. Follow me on Twitter at boot_sequence. It should be right here. Don't forget to drop a comment with what you thought of today's stories. As usual, you can click right here to see the latest video. Right here to subscribe to the channel. It would be greatly appreciated. Stay frosty, and I'll see you on the next one. Take care, boys. Wait, I was supposed to... Anyways, bye.